In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Today's theme of khutbah is the virtue of dua. All praise is due to Allah, the one who hears all supplications, the remover of trials and tribulations. I bear witness that no deity worthy of worship except Allah alone. He has a most beautiful name. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is his servant and messenger. All you who believe, fear Allah and know that man is helpless and weak in reality. Allah the Almighty says, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, I possess no power to benefit or hurt myself except as Allah wills. If I had the knowledge of the unseen, I would have secured for myself an abundance of wealth and no evil should have touched me. I am but a warner and bringer of glad tidings unto people who believe. Surah Al-A'raf. If this is the respect to the leader of mankind, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, how much less is the situation of those below him. Among the greatest act of worship is dua. Allah the Exalted said, and our Lord says, invoke me, I'll respond to your invocation. Verily, those who scorn my worship, they will surely enter hell in humiliation. Surah Ghafir. This verse refers to both dua al-ibadah and the dua of mas'ala. The dua of ibadah, that is invocation of worship, is any kind of worship prescribed by Allah upon Muslim as mandatory or commendable. To seek Allah's pleasure and to ask Allah through that worship goodness and seek Allah's protection from any evils. The dua of mas'ala, that is invocation of need, is to ask Allah for a specific need, such as cure and recovery from an ailment, sustenance, elimination of sorrow and distress, debt discharge, entering the paradise and rescue from hell. And Nu'man ibn Bashir radiallahu an reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, dua, supplication is worship. Abu Dawud narrated. Also Anas radiallahu an reported that the Messenger of Allah said, dua is the backbone, that means the essence of ibadah, worship. Supplicating Allah is our greatest chance of having our need granted and achieving any goodness in this world and the hereafter, and freeing our soul from trials and tribulations. The needs of man, the means of man being are many and endless. Allah the Almighty grants any need, to matter how many. Allah says in the Hadith al-Qudusi reported by Abu Dharr, O my servant, where the first of you and the last of you, the woman and of you and the jinn of you, to rise up in one place and make a request from me, and where I to give everyone what they requested, that would not decrease what I have any more than a needle decreases the sea if put into it. Exalted is Allah, and no one has to be worshipped except Him alone. Languages are never ambiguous to Him, despite the many voices and the various needs and constant invocations all the time. Allah says, whosoever is in the heavens and on the earth begs of him his needs from him, every day he is engaged in some affairs. Abu Darda reported, the Messenger of Allah said, that means such as forgiving sins, removing sorrow, answering calls, giving honor or disgracing some, taking light of some, reported Abu Bazar. One of the scholars said, I noticed that every goodness is in obedience of Allah. Then I noticed furthermore that the entire goodness is in dua, supplication. Among the pitfalls of a servant is to lose the opportunity of making dua and fall in evils. Abdullah bin Umar reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, whomsoever of you the door of supplication is opened for, the door of mercy has been opened for him. And Allah is not asked for anything more beloved to him than being asked for al-afiyah, good health. And the Messenger of Allah said, the supplications benefit against that which strikes and that doesn't strike. So hold fast, O worshippers of Allah, to supplications. Also Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrated, the Messenger of Allah said, nothing most honored to Allah than dua. The supplicating person is in worship and his reward is abundant. Ubadah ibn Samit narrated, the Messenger of Allah said, whenever a Muslim supplicates to Allah, he accepts his supplications or averts any similar kind of trouble from him until he prays for something sinful or something that may break the ties of kinship. Upon this, some of the companion said, then we shall supplicate a lot. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah is much more than that in responding. Dua has appeared as a very significant effect in the life of Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destroyed disbelievers with dua of Noah alayhi salam. Allah said, then he invoked his Lord saying, I have been overcome, so help me Allah. Surah Al-Qamar. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, conquered the troop of Quraysh disbelievers in Badr with the dua of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this ummah with the dua of Prophet Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by choosing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for this ummah. He bestowed Zakariya with Yahya after old age, and he saved all the messengers and those with them from the oppressor with the dua. All you who believe, supplication is commendable for Muslim all the time. Even Allah, disbelieving person, Allah answers his dua when he is oppressed by someone. Dua has etiquettes and circumstances that need to be followed to achieve success. Number one, obedience of Allah in his commands and abstaining from his prohibitions. Number two, sincerity and consciousness of mind. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, call upon Allah while being certain of being answered. And Allah doesn't respond to a supplication from the heart of a heedless mind and occupied by play. Number three, praising Allah and glorifying him, then sending peace and blessing of Allah upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number four, do not be hasty in dua. Abu Huraira narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the invocation of any one of you is granted by Allah as long as he doesn't show impatience by saying, I have invoked Allah, but my request has not been answered. Number four, giving a sadaqah during the dua and facing al-qibla. Number five, among the conditions of accepting dua is halal sustenance, food and clothes. The Messenger of Allah said to Sa'd bin Waqqas, O Sa'd, make your food tayyib, means halal. Your prayer be granted. He became mustajab dua, the one whose prayers are granted always. The times where supplications are answered are as follows. Number one, after breaking a fast. Number two, the last third of the night. Number three, while running. Number four, while seeing Kaaba. Number five, when traveling. Number six, the time between Adhan and Iqama. Number seven, after the conclusion of obligatory prayers. Number eight, a short period of time before the Maghrib on Friday. The bounty of Allah is so great. He answers whosoever calls him. And he is so angry to whosoever doesn't ask him. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah said, the person who doesn't ask from Allah Ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala becomes angry with him. The best of supplications is the dua of the prophets, and the best of it is saying, Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Allah the Almighty says, invoke your Lord with humility and in secret. He lacks not the aggressors, and do not do mischief on the earth after it has been set in order, and invoke him with fear and hope. Surely Allah's mercy is ever near unto the good doers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our supplications. May He grant our needs in this dunya and hereafter. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.